So hello students, welcome to today's lesson. Hope you have been keeping safe at home. But as we continue today with our lesson for today. So, today I want to introduce another topic. Remember previously we've been dealing with the concept of the differentiation. So today we'll be referring to the reverse of that differentiation, which is going to be the integration part. So it's going to be the opposite, or it's going to be the reverse of what you have been doing in our previous topic. So on the part that we're going to focus on it today is going to be the part of the introduction. And on this introduction concept, I'll be speaking on some few issues which we need to be able to consider, and then we try to compare with what you have been doing. So you as a learner, what are the objectives are you supposed to understand at the end of this topic? I have categorized most of them, the objective, but you're supposed to be in a position to be able to understand. So number one, I'm saying you must be in a position to be able to carry out the process of the differentiation. Remember the process of the differentiation? Just want to emphasize on one thing, in this case, the introduction. So the process of the differentiation, we say few issues here. And we agree that if you have been given a function, let's say you have been given y is equals to 3x r to the power 5, we understand that the process of the differentiation, we agree that is only you lower the power, and when you lower the power, you multiply by the coefficient. So that is going to be 3 multiplied by 5, then from there reduce the power by 1. So that is going to be x, then 5 minus 1. So at the end of the day, you can have this going to be 15, then x to the power 4. Then again in part B, where you have been given y is equals to 3, maybe let's say 6x. Then you agreed on this issue. You have to be very keen. So here to understand that there is an x to the power 1. So if you lower the power, so this one can be interpreted as 6x to the power 1. So when you lower the power, it's going to be 6 multiplied by 1. Then you reduce the power by 1. So it's going to be x, 1 minus 1. Then you get what? So you get your 6x to the power 0. Thereby we said any number is power 0 is going to be 1. So this is 6 multiplied by 1, which our answer is going to be 6. So when the power is the power of the variable is 1, then at the end of the day you get a figure without any variable. Then again we agree on part C, but if you have something like y is equals to, let's say, 5x, 5, then you are told to differentiate this one with respect to x. We agree that here there is an x to the power 0, so this is x or 0. So if you lower the power, this one is going to be 5 multiplied by 0. Then x 0 minus 1. So at the end of the day, you can have this is going to be 0, then x to the power negative 1, which is giving us 0. So we agreed that the differential of a constant will always give you 0 there. So that's what you're saying. You as a learner, you are supposed to be in a position to be able to carry out the process of the differentiation like you have been doing previously. Then B is that you are supposed to interpret the integration as the reverse process of the differentiation. So this process which you are moving up from here, so it's going to be the opposite of it. So you're going to come from here, the answer, then we move back to the original equation. So that's what we are saying, that in this case, we are going to be interpreting integration as the reverse process of the differentiation. So for you to understand integration, which is our topic now, we must be in a process to understand differentiation, because integration is the reverse of differentiation there. Then part C is saying you are also supposed to relate integration notation to the sum of the area of the trapezium under the curve. Then apart from that, this is only going to be focusing on it. The integral polynomial. Then E, apply integration in finding the area under the curve. And then the same case, we are saying applying the integration to find the area under the curve. We have to relate with what we did when you are finding the maxima and the minima area. Then F is the applying integration in kinematics. Just like we did in the case of the differentiation, we applied the differentiation in the process of the velocity, acceleration, and displacement. So in this case, we're going to apply that knowledge of integration in a subtopic that is going to be known as the kinematics. Then the content which you're talking about, you have the content there, still the same, differentiation, reverse of the differentiation, integration notation, then the sum of the area of the trapezium. Then again we talk about the indefinite and the definite integrals. then the area under covered by integration, and then the application in the pneumatic. So at the end of this topic, you as a learner, those are the issues that must be on your fingertips so that you can be able to attend any question then in your final exam or any standard exam that you're going to be given. Now I'll start with the part of the introduction, whereby I'm going to introduce the concept of the differentiation. The concept of the integration. So in the introductory part, just only need to look to emphasize on what you're saying. And you're saying that the process of finding a function, the process of finding a function from the gradient function or the derived function is known as the integration. So the process in which you are finding the function from the derivative. So I give you the derivative, then I tell you to find the function. That process is what we are referring as the integration. And then I'm telling you, suppose we differentiate the function. Suppose we differentiate the function, that is number one. I give you the function which is y is equals 2. Y is equals to x squared. Then I tell you to differentiate this function. You get the dy, so you differentiate with respect to x. So the dy dx. So it will be on the normal way that you are going to obtain. That is going over the power here is 1, so 1 times 2. Then this is x squared minus 1. So at the end of the day we have 2, then x to the power 1, which is going to be 2x. So also they are insisting there that suppose we differentiate that function, we get our dy dx is going to be 2x. Let it alone, cameraman, is okay, it goes there on the board. That's what you are saying, that the dy dx is going to be 2x. Then integration reverses this process. That's what I want you to understand, that the integration reverses this process. So if this is the derivative, then I tell you to integrate. I tell you now here number 2, then integrate, then 2x, then your answer is supposed to be x squared. Also we can see that the integration is the reverse of differentiation. So you, the function was y x squared, you differentiated with respect to x, you get your 2x, then I tell you to integrate the 2x, then you obtain the x squared. So let's say integration reverses this process, and we say that the integral of 2x is x squared. So there my cameraman will focus on it. That's the process you're talking about there. I hope you can be able to see it. Is it clear? You can be able to see it. So that's what we are saying. We have the two concepts here. We have the differentiate, and then we have integrate. So in this case, also you're saying integrate there. Indeed. So integrate. So in this case, you had your 2x, differentiate, you get your 2x. So when you get your 2x, then integrate, you get your x squared. So when you have x squared, you differentiate, you get 2x. So you can see, it is a process that is going to be the opposite of each other. So that is the thing that we are saying, that the two of them are connected, and one of them is the reverse of the other. One of them is the reverse of the other. So how do you go about it now? So, from differentiation, we know that the gradient is not always a constant. That one we agree, that when I give you the curve, the gradient will keep on changing depending on the point on the curve that you're putting into consideration. That's why we are saying that from differentiation, the gradient is not always constant. Now I'm saying that, for example, if the dy dx is equal to x, then this comes from the function of the form y is equals to x squared plus c, where c is the constant. That's why we have to say that c is representing, that smaller thing. Because you see, when you consider the curve, then at each and every different point, the gradient keep on changing. That's why we say the dy dx is going to be 2x, then this comes from the function of the form y is equal to x squared plus c, where c is the constant. So for example, I've given you some examples there. We're going to understand what we're talking about there. In this example, we insist that if I tell you, if find y, if the dy dx is 3x squared. So give me the dy dx, that is number one. Then I tell you find y. So I've given you dy. Dy dx is going to be the dual yes is 3x prime. Then I tell you, the question is, find one. So meaning this one is the derivative. And then this one is the function. So we have said, if you have the derivative, and you need to go back to the function, what you do to this derivative, you don't differentiate, but now you integrate. That's what I'm saying in my working here, as you can see. That's what you're saying. Part of the solution I'm insisting, that the dy dx, is equals to 3x squared. Then y should be given by what? Y should be given by x cubed. Now c, that's the concept that I'm saying. I will be explaining that concept. Again, if I give you the dy dx, number 2, you need to be able to achieve, how are we achieving this one? So the dy dx is what? I give you the dy dx is going to be 4s cubed. Then I tell you to find the y. Then you say, your y is going to be given by x over 4 plus c. That's the idea. So in my next part of the slide, I will be explaining what are we talking about in that case of the differentiation. So that one, we are going to see it in the next part of the video. And with that, I am out.